Hi, welcome to the WTAMU Virtual Math Lab. This video will step you through College Algebra Tutorial 23A, Example 1. In this example, we want to solve the quadratic inequality x squared plus 2x minus 15 is less than 0 by using the sign of graph factors, write our answer in interval notation, and graph the solution set. In Step 1, we want to write the quadratic inequality in standard form. This means we want to set the quadratic expression either greater than or less than 0. The reason we are doing this is 0 is our magic number. It is the only number that separates the negatives from the positives. If an expression is greater than 0, then there is no doubt that its sign is positive. Likewise, if it is less than 0, its sign is negative. We cannot say this about any other number. Since we are working with inequalities, this idea will come in handy. With this technique, we will be looking at the sign of a number to determine if it's a solution or not. This inequality is already in standard form. In Step 2, we want to set up what we found in Step 1 as a quadratic equation and solve it by factoring to get the boundary points. The boundary points will mark off where the quadratic expression is equal to 0. This is like the crossover point, because 0 is neither positive nor negative. So our equation is x squared plus 2x minus 15 equals 0. This trinomial will factor as x plus 5 times x minus 3, and we still have it equal to 0. Using the zero product principle, we can set each factor equal to 0 and get x plus 5 equals 0, or x minus 3 equals 0. In the first linear equation, we can do the inverse and subtract 5 from both sides and get x plus 5 minus 5 equals 0 minus 5, which simplifies to be x equals negative 5. In the second linear equation, we can add 3 to both sides and get x minus 3 plus 3 equals 0 plus 3, which simplifies to be x equals 3. So it looks like we have two boundary points, negative 5 and 3. In Step 3, we want to use the boundary points from Step 2 to mark off test intervals on the number line and list all the factors found in Step 2. Here, we have marked off our boundary points of negative 5 and 3. Note that we are using open holes at the two points because our original inequality did not include where it is equal to 0. Note that our boundary points mark off three sections on the graph, negative infinity to negative 5, negative 5 to 3, and 3 to infinity. We will list the two factors that we found, x plus 5 and x minus 3, on the side. In Step 4, we need to find the sign of every factor in every interval. When we do this, we can choose any point in an interval to represent that interval. Once we choose this value, we will plug it into each factor and determine if the sign of that factor is either positive or negative. Let's go ahead and choose negative 6 from the first interval of negative infinity to negative 5. Plugging a negative 6 into the first factor, we get negative 6 plus 5 equals negative 1. Since we got a negative number, the sign of that factor in that interval is negative. Now let's plug negative 6 into the other factor and get a negative 6 minus 3, which equals negative 9. So it looks like we have another negative factor in that interval. Moving to the second interval of negative 5 to 3, let's go ahead and choose 0 to plug in. This will give us 0 plus 5 equals 5 for the top factor, which means that factor is positive for that interval. Plugging 0 into the second factor, we get 0 minus 3 equals a negative 3, so this factor is negative in that second interval. Let's check out that last interval of 3 to infinity. Let's choose 4 to plug into x plus 5 and get 4 plus 5 equals 9. Since 9 is positive, that factor is positive in that last interval. Plugging the 4 into x minus 3, we get 4 minus 3 equals 1, which means this factor is also positive in that last interval. In step 5, we want to use the signs found in step 4 and determine the sign of the overall quadratic function in each interval. In the first interval of negative infinity to negative 5, we would have a negative times a negative, so the sign of the product of those two factors is positive. In the second interval of negative 5 to 3, we would have a positive times a negative, so that sign of the product of those two factors is negative. In the third interval of 3 to infinity, we would have a positive times a positive, so the sign of the product of those two factors is positive. In step 6, we want to write the solution set in interval notation and graph it. Remember that the original inequality in standard form is x squared plus 2x minus 15 is less than 0. To be less than 0 means that the quadratic has to be negative. Looking at the bottom line, it looks like there is one interval where the quadratic is negative, the second one, which is negative 5 to 3. Since we are not including the endpoints, this will be an open interval, and we will use curved ends to indicate this. So our final answer for the interval notation is the open interval from negative 5 to 3. Last, we need to graph this. The graph will look like the interval notation. We will have a curved end at negative 5 and a curved end at 3 and shade everything in between for our final answer for the graph.